Welcome to the Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. Tonight on Monday Night Raw, Liv Morgan takes on Mandy Rose for the United States Championship Tournament. Goldust will be taking on Matt Hardy for number one contendership of the Fight Zone World Wrestling Championship. And in our main event, we see Dean Ambrose for the last time. Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins team up together, The Shield, against Leo Rush and Bobby Lashley in a tag team match.
The following contest is a championship first round match. Making her way to the ring, accompanied by Sarah Logan and Ruby Riott, representing the Riott Squad from Elmwood Park, New Jersey, Liv Morgan.
The Riott Squad makes their way to the ring. Only Liv Morgan's participating in this match. This is the United States Championship Tournament. Liv Morgan or Mandy Rose of Absolution are the only two that are going to be moving up in this tournament. One of the two, I should say. Let's see how it goes, though. Will it favor Liv Morgan, or will it favor this woman coming to the ring, Mandy Rose?
And her opponent, accompanied by Sonya Deville and Paige, representing Absolution from Yorktown Heights, New York, Mandy Rose.
The Legends of Wrestling, Lacey Evans, defeated Kansas LeRae to move up in the United States Championship Tournament. And now Mandy Rose is hoping to do the same. Maria also defeated Naomi by disqualification. She brought a weapon in the ring. Naomi used it. So because of that, Naomi was the one that was disqualified. And Maria moved up. So Maria Kanellis has a chance to become United States Champion as well. Right now we're going to figure out who else has a chance. Will it be Liv Morgan, or will Mandy Rose get the best of her here tonight on Raw? And also a championship that Matt Hardy has tried to get his hands on throughout his time here on Fight Zone Wrestling. The FZW World Championship, currently held by Bobby Lashley. Matt Hardy has a chance to become the number one contender for that title. As we go back about a year ago when him and Jeff Hardy, about almost 2 years ago now, him and Jeff Hardy were battling for that number one contendership. Jeff Hardy ended up beating Matt and becoming world champion. He would hold on to that championship until he was defeated by Nathan Smart, and Nathan was then taken out by Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar ended up losing that championship in a three-way match with Chris Jericho and The Miz. The Miz ended up becoming champion, and then Bobby Lashley defeating The Miz to become the new world champion. And Matt Hardy has somewhat disappeared through a lot of that, and now he has an opportunity to finally, hopefully, become world champion maybe. He'll have to go through Goldust if he wants that dream to become a reality. Goldust, let's not count him out though. He's been trying to capture that World Heavyweight Championship for years in his career. He has never been the world champion. This is his opportunity at the championship. And after he defeats Matt Hardy, he would then have to go through Bobby Lashley, which is no easy task at all. And Bobby Lashley ended up getting a world championship match when he went up against Brock Lesnar. A lot of people feel that Bobby Lashley beat Brock Lesnar, but the referee did not count that three. And so Bobby Lashley ended up getting the title match and ended up winning the title. Simple as that. But where's Brock Lesnar in all of this? Has he disappeared again? Will he be back here in Fight Zone Wrestling? Remains to be seen. For now, though, let's focus on this United States Championship Tournament between Mandy Rose and Liv Morgan. Nice knee there by Mandy Rose. Could she get it? No. Liv Morgan kicks out, but that almost could have been it. Liv Morgan in a bit of trouble now. Mandy Rose has Liv Morgan in the corner. And also still to come here tonight, the match between Mojo Rawley and Randy Orton will be next week here on Raw for the Intercontinental Championship. Here tonight, though, the FZWX Division Championship, Rey Mysterio will be defending that title against Oney Lorcan. And now Mandy Rose has Liv Morgan in trouble now in that corner. Liv Morgan needs to find a way to get out of this. Mandy Rose, wait a minute. A steel chair thrown in the ring right now. Paige isn't too happy about that, trying to get the referee's attention, but doesn't matter right now. Mandy Rose is in trouble. It's the Riot Squad versus Absolution right now. Liv Morgan versus Mandy Rose, and Liv Morgan might move up in this tournament. No, she's gonna throw Liv Morgan off with that steel chair still close by. And I don't like the looks of it. Oh, Liv Morgan goes down. Sarah Logan trying to help Liv Morgan here at this point. But the referee right there, that steel chair is right in his viewpoint. Right. Oh, wait a minute. Roll up by Liv Morgan. Here we go. One, two. Oh, not even going to be a two count. She kicked out. The steel chair thankfully falls out of the ring. Oh, no, it's still up in the apron. Never mind. Oh, look at this. The 201 from Liv Morgan. One, two, three. No, a two count. A two count, and Mandy Rose kicks out. Able to still stay in this match. Mandy Rose. And she's getting a little more aggressive now on Liv Morgan. She almost was moments away from losing this match. Liv Morgan not able to put Mandy Rose away somehow. Can Mandy Rose put Liv Morgan away though with the Angel's Wings? Hooks the leg. Oh, but look, Sarah Logan now distracting the referee. That should have been all she wrote right there, but Liv Morgan. Luckily, she had some backup from Sarah. And Ruby Riott threatening her with that steel chair now. Pay attention to Liv Morgan, though, Mandy. Stay focused on Liv Morgan. She's the one in this match. She's the one you need to stay focused on. Who will be the first woman to become United States champion? Look at this, Liv Morgan. Tries to roll her up really quick, but she's too close to the ropes. Bulldog. Trish Stratus has put a lot of women away with that. But look at this, Liv Morgan's in trouble now. Mandy Rose rolls her up. One, two, kick out. Liv Morgan rolling out of the ring to safety. Liv Morgan just trips Mandy Rose up on the apron. And now here we go. Both women are back in the ring here. Liv Morgan thrown off though, and now Mandy Rose. Power slam by Mandy Rose. What an incredible athlete Mandy is. She's not just all looks, ladies and gentlemen, but Liv Morgan's able to get the shoulder up again. A lot of resiliency shown from Liv Morgan here tonight. Gotta give her credit too. What a match here tonight between these ladies. And now Mandy Rose. She's looking to go high risk off that middle rope. Drop kick didn't work. Liv Morgan moved out of the way. And now the guillotine again is trapped. Mandy Rose is in trouble. No, wait a minute, she lets go. Could have been losing her grip, maybe. She thought it was best to let go, maybe, instead of trying to finish her off. We'll risk Mandy Rose countering it again. Snapmare. Oh, kick to the face of Mandy Rose. But this time, it works. The boot to the back. Oh, wait a minute. Liv Morgan gets back up to her feet, though. 201 again. The 201. One, two. The second time she's able to put Mandy Rose away. And now Liv Morgan moves up in the United States Championship Tournament. Congratulations to Liv Morgan. We gotta give credit to Mandy Rose, though. She tried everything she had. She took a loss tonight, but she put on an incredible effort. And unfortunately, it just was not enough to put Liv Morgan away. She probably would have had her with the Angel's Wings, but Sarah Logan got involved. Could that have been the difference maker?
Here is your winner, Liv Morgan.
Still to come tonight, the X Division Championship. Rey Mysterio defends his title against Oney Lorcan. And then Bobby Lashley will team up with Leo Rush to take on Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins of The Shield. Wait, that's Adam. Oh, what the hell? That's Adam Cole and Chad Gable. Is this about Legends of Wrestling? What Mike Kanellis and Adam Cole did to Kurt Angle, forcing Kurt Angle into retirement. It looks like Chad Gable, he's defending Kurt Angle's honor right now, taking out Adam Cole in the back. Where's Mike Kanellis though? Does Mike Kanellis even know what's going on right now? I hate to say it, you know, I feel like Adam Cole deserves this. I mean, he pissed a lot of people off for what they did to Kurt Angle and then what they did to Jason Jordan. Jason Jordan and Kurt Angle are both injured, out with an injury. And oh, Adam Cole gets put through a table. There's chaos in the back right now. We got to move on to Oney Lorcan versus Rey Mysterio tonight, though. We're going to have to see what happens to Adam Cole. Get some kind of update or something.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the FZW Extreme Championship.
Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Moving on to Oney Lorcan and Rey Mysterio. Once we get an update, though, on Adam Cole's condition, we will tell you all about it. You know, Mike Kanellis and Adam Cole may have become the new tag team champions, but they are not favorites in the backstage area in the locker room. As you can clearly see by what just happened in the locker room with Chad Gable. Can Oney Lorcan, can he win the X Division Championship here tonight, though? If he can defeat Rey Mysterio, the Cruiserweight legend himself, will become the new X Division champion. Here we go. Rey Mysterio, multiple time Cruiserweight champion. He's now X Division champion. The X Division Championship, formerly known as the FZW Cruiserweight Championship, renamed by Matt Hardy. Matt Hardy going to promote No Limits. You know, Rey Mysterio, former No Limits soldier himself. I bet that's perfect for him as X Division Champion. Let's see what Rey Mysterio can do up against his opponent, Oney Lorcan, here tonight. Let's not count Oney Lorcan out. He may be one of the newest guys in the wrestling business today, but Rey Mysterio, he's better be careful. Oney Lorcan is a different kind. A different kind of athlete. He can fly when he wants to, but he's mostly known for his wrestling skills.
Introducing the challenger.
His technicality.
From Boston, Massachusetts. Weighing in at 190 pounds, Oney Lorcan.
This is an incredible opportunity for Oney Lorcan to make a name for himself. He better make the best of it.
Introducing the champion from San Diego, California, weighing in at 175 pounds. He is the FZW Extreme Champion, Rey Mysterio.
The X Division Champion, Rey Mysterio. He won that championship after defeating Kalisto. But this opens up the door for more of those cruiserweight style wrestlers that aren't exactly at cruiserweight weight. Samoa Joe, for example. Rey Mysterio, better watch out for Samoa Joe. He could qualify for that X Division Championship. Cassius Ohno, I would think, as well as Kevin Owens. Guys, they are great athletes, great high flyers, but definitely not a cruiserweight. They fit that X Division Championship style. Rey Mysterio getting hung up on the ropes here. Northern Lights suplex, beautiful bridge there. Oney Lorcan reminds me of Dean Malenko, Eddie Guerrero, and Chris Jericho, guys that aren't really known as high flyers, more known for their technical wrestling and high flying skills in the cruiserweight division. Mysterio, nice turnaround there, taking down Oney Lorcan. It's back and forth between the two. Oh, German suplex holds him. And a lariat taking down Rey Mysterio, turning him inside out. But Rey Mysterio's back up. Oney Lorcan making the mistake of thinking Rey Mysterio was down and out. Not going to be the case, though. Look at this wrist lock into a hurricane run. Nicely done. Rey Mysterio drives Oney Lorcan to the mat. And now a powerbomb. Oney Lorcan, no, rolls right behind Rey Mysterio. One, two. Only a two count. Rey Mysterio not able to keep him down. Or Oney Lorcan, excuse me, not able to keep Rey Mysterio down. And Rey Mysterio may pay for it right now. Oney Lorcan with those devastating slaps. And a knee across the head. And now Oney Lorcan. Oh, it looks like he was going to end it right there. It didn't work out. Rey Mysterio. Nope. Oney Lorcan takes control. Clothesline. Forcing Rey Mysterio down. Here we go now with the elbows. Now looks like Rey Mysterio is in a bit of trouble here. Powerbomb this time by Oney Lorcan. Oh, into a diamond cutter! If he can go for the pin, he may be the new X Division champion right here. Go for the pin, Lorcan! He's not going for the pin. He's instead waiting for Rey Mysterio to get to his feet. Could be a bad mistake here. Don't know why Lorcan didn't go for the pin. Bulldog though by Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio is not going to let up this opportunity right now. He's going to take advantage. Clothesline right over the top rope. Oney Lorcan goes out. Bad mistake by Oney Lorcan not going for the pin. And now Rey Mysterio is in control of this match. Turns things around. It's going to be hard for Oney Lorcan to try and get things in his court now. Get the ball rolling in his court. Look at Rey Mysterio. Rolls through with the Hurricanrana. One, two. kick out. Oney Lorcan almost lost the match, though. He needs to stay focused here. And now Rey Mysterio. Uh-oh, Oney Lorcan. Able to throw him over the top rope, but Rey Mysterio kicks him right in his face. Cross body. One, two. Kick out by Oney Lorcan. And now Rey Mysterio has Oney. He's going for that Hurricane Rana again. No, this time he hung him up on the ropes. 619. Rey Mysterio may end it here. Oney Lorcan moves out of the way. Oh, and Lorcan was trying to take advantage, but Rey Mysterio had an elbow waiting for him. That was a forearm that time. Maybe an elbow. I don't know from this vantage point. It looked like a forearm to me. Doesn't matter. All it affected Oney Lorcan. That's the bottom line. Look at Oney. Oh, he's trying to go for a clothesline. It looked like didn't work. Rey Mysterio tries to go under, but Oney grabs that arm and takes advantage. Here we go. Diamond and wrist lock. Ooh, elbow to the shoulder. Takes him out from behind with a neck breaker. Rey Mysterio gets back up, but Oney Lorcan doesn't care. Oh, Rey Mysterio lands on his feet. Hurricane Rana. Oh, he hung him up on the ropes again. Rey Mysterio going for it again. Down in San Diego with the 619. The splash by Rey Mysterio. Hooks the leg with a second time work. One, two, three. And Rey Mysterio retains the X Division Championship. What a match from these two incredible athletes tonight on Monday Night Raw. This was the first 619. Boom! Oney Lorcan went down, but he moved out of the way from that frog splash by Rey Mysterio. But the second time, he was not too lucky. Look at this. Rey Mysterio landing on his feet, turns things around in his favor, hung him up on the rope with 619, a splash, and ended the match. Rey Mysterio retains the title.
FZW Extreme Champion, Rey.
Ladies and gentlemen, when we return, the number one contenders match, Gold Dust and Matt Hardy.
No fear, no fear. Blood, sweat, no tears. My God, it's God's grace I'm here. No fear, no fear. Blood, sweat, no tears. My God, hope we make it through the years.
How many knows it will yet?
The dirtiest, roughest, hard-pounding, most extreme show on YouTube.
XVPW Universe, you see, we don't do things like the regular guys over there at COH, El Dorado, and American Wrestling Federation. See, we do things to the extreme.
She go for a pin. Looks like she's capitalizing this, pinning his security. This is the pin that you asked for. It's DEANT ALBO!
It's not that we don't like the other federations, we just like doing things a little bit better.
What are you waiting for? It's time to get
extreme. Welcome back to Fight Zone Wrestling's Monday Night Raw. Goldust awaiting Matt Hardy to make his arrival. There's a lot riding on this match for Matt Hardy. This is his opportunity, his chance to become the world champion. This match was given to Matt Hardy from Vince McMahon.
And his opponent,
so he didn't hand himself this title opportunity.
Money, weighing in at 236 pounds, Matt Hardy.
Now, something to remember is Matt Hardy is responsible for this universe being broken, responsible for the return of Eddie Guerrero, responsible for Sheldon Mondo and guys like Milk and those guys disappearing. They've been overtaken by former WWE superstars, current WWE superstars, WCW, Impact Wrestling, stars from all over the universe because of Matt Hardy. And Matt Hardy, the whole reason he wants to become the world champion is because that will fix the universe, apparently. So let's see if Matt Hardy can defeat Goldust tonight to get that opportunity at Bobby Lashley's World Championship. Matt Hardy is trying to save the universe of FZW. As crazy as it sounds, it seems to be correct in what he's feeling, what he thinks. And, I mean, come on. Carter Ramirez sold the company to the McMahons. And there was a lot of confusion there. Eddie Guerrero ended up buying the company. And then, you know, after he took abuse of his power, the company somehow ended up in the hands of Vince McMahon once again. Well, it ended up in the hands of Paul Heyman. And then all of a sudden it went bankrupt, which is unrealistic that it would go bankrupt after one show. I don't know what the hell happened to the money that Paul Heyman had, but apparently FZW went bankrupt until it was bought by Vince McMahon. And now, thankfully, we have Vince McMahon to thank for FZW still being around. Paul Heyman almost killed FZW. But right now, Matt Hardy's trying to do something deeper than just saving this company. He's trying to save the whole universe. I just sound like a crazy guy right now. Let's just see if Matt Hardy can win this match against Goldust. You cannot count Goldust out. Goldust is an incredible athlete. It seems he only gets better with age. And right now, here tonight, Goldust wants to become the World Heavyweight Champion. This is his opportunity as well. He has to go through Matt Hardy, though. Matt Hardy's been chasing his title for years here in Fight Zone Wrestling. He's not able to defeat Sheldon Mondo, but tonight could be his night. Let's see how it goes. Let's see what happens. Goldust now with a headlock. And this doesn't seem like a friendly match right now. This seems more of like Goldust being very focused here, which is a good thing for Goldust. He needs to be focused on Matt Hardy. He can't take it easy. Both these guys are veterans. Goldust shaking that elbow off. Didn't look like Matt Hardy got a lot on it. Back and forth these guys go right now. And now Matt Hardy has Goldust in the corner with a clothesline and a bulldog. Goldust has had an interesting year. Last year, 2018, you'll remember Goldust having somewhat of a personality disorder, I think would be the best way to explain that. I mean, he showed up as 7. Goldust and Dustin Rhodes in that Royal Rumble match. Matt Hardy was going for the Twist of Fate. Unfortunately, it was not going to happen here tonight, not yet. And then we saw Goldust, how he showed up, not even in his wrestling clothes, just in a regular suit. Last time we saw him against Kane, and I mean, it's just been confusing for Goldust. It's been really interesting. Hopefully, he's found himself. He's realized this is who he is. He's Goldust. He's got to be the best that he can be. If he wants all the gold, he's got to latch on. Just get serious. There's no one to blame but himself right now for why he hasn't had much more success, because he's getting an opportunity right here, right now. And I'm not trying to say that it would be Goldust's fault if he lost this match. I mean, who else can you blame, though? It would be Goldust's fault. Not like it's a bad thing. Matt Hardy's just a better wrestler if he wins tonight. There's a lot riding on this championship opportunity right now. Championship implications on the line. But they're not even implications. It's contendership. Goldust, there it is, the curtain call. He may have just beat Matt Hardy here. Matt Hardy, he kicks out before a one count. The referee took a long time getting there, though. The Goldust, he's mad. He probably would have had it right there, but what a slap. The referee was, he took too long getting there. Now we're about to see what happens. Goldust going for a neck breaker. Matt Hardy counters into a spinning heel kick. And now Matt Hardy, man, he may be feeling his second win coming on right now. Matt Hardy, scoop slam. Goes behind, taking his time. So, ooh. Nice neck breaker there. Slow and decisive, not rushing into anything. Wait a minute. Went for another twist of fate. And Goldust able to counter it for a second time. Impressive from Goldust here. Able to counter the twist of fate for a second time in this match. And now Goldust is going up. We've seen him do some pretty crazy things going from that top rope. Oh, Matt Hardy gets kicked away. Now Goldust, Hurricane Rana, hooks the legs, one. Oh, only gonna be a one count. Now a suplex from Matt Hardy, no. Goldust able to counter it. Uh-oh. Director's cut. Goldust with director's cut. Another finishing maneuver. That's it. One, two. Matt Hardy's chance. No! It's still going. Goldust not able to put Matt Hardy away with two finishing maneuvers that he's used to put away matches. And somehow Matt Hardy was able to kick out both of them. Wait a minute, schoolboy! Goldust wasn't paying attention. One, only a one count. Wow. Ooh, a back elbow there off the face of Matt Hardy by Goldust. What can Goldust do to try to put Matt Hardy away? He's given everything he's got. Two moves that he's finished multiple opponents off with. He just kicked out of. That's a problem for Matt Hardy. Oh, wait a minute. Crossroads! Crossroads from Goldust! One! Two! Oh, he got the ropes this time! Are you kidding me? Goldust is doing everything he can to win this match, but Matt Hardy is so smart with his broken brilliance. He's proclaimed himself woken. And ever since then, he's been such a much smarter person, not just a better athlete. Able to take Goldust down. Matt Hardy needs to try to come back in this match and do something that will help him, that will aid him in winning this match and getting the victory to become the new number one contender for Bobby Lashley's championship. Who's going on to FZW Backlash? Who's going to be taking on Bobby Lashley for that world championship? Remember in FZW, wait a minute. In FZW, we've seen Matt Hardy in that ladder match with Jeff Hardy about a year ago now. I think that was the last time we really saw Matt Hardy full time. Matt Hardy trying to end it with another twist of fate. Didn't work. Gold Dust. It's the curtain call. Hooks the leg. One, two. Are you kidding me? Gold Dust still not able to put Matt Hardy away. This time with a curtain call. That is incredible. And now Gold Dust, Matt Hardy in control, twist of fate. But Gold Dust for the fourth time, the third time, able to counter that twist of fate. That's the fourth time Gold Dust has been able to counter the twist of fate. And now another director's cut by Gold Dust. I apologize if I call any of his moves by the wrong name. He's had about three different kinds of moves named the curtain call, the director's cut. Crossroads now again on Matt Hardy. Now Gold Dust, he's just doing everything right now, it seems. And Matt Hardy, it's a bad thing for him because he hasn't been able to counter any of it. And Gold Dust, look at this, complete shot. Is he going to end it here now? That's a move he used when he was on ECW. Two. No, are you kidding me? Matt Hardy will not die. He's living up to his name right now. It's not just a catchphrase. DDT, he's going to try and do it with a Jake Snake special. And he's not able to do it there either. Gold Dust is doing everything he can to beat Matt Hardy. But Matt Hardy will not die. Suplex. If Matt Hardy hits that twist of fate, you better believe this match is all over. Another curtain call. Matt Hardy goes down and he didn't get back up. Oh my God, Gold Dust. Oh! Gold Dust is angry right now. Look at this. Matt Hardy able to counter it. Matt Hardy coming back here. And now Matt Hardy, will he realize? Will he finally make that dream, that premonition become a reality? Matt Hardy, next world champion. Will he get his shot against Bobby Lashley at Backlash? He's taking down Gold Dust. Here we go. Tornado punch. Gold Dust goes down. And now Matt Hardy with the elbows over the head of Gold Dust. And this is Matt Hardy's fate right now. This is his destiny. This is where he came to Fight Zone Wrestling 4 years ago. And now Matt Hardy is about to put Gold Dust away for a world championship match against Bobby Lashley. Face first into the turnbuckle. Oh, try to hit his head against the turnbuckle. Goldust able to counter it that second time, though. Goes behind him. A right hand. Back body toss by Matt Hardy. Oh, and a boot to the face. Could this be the end? Is he signaling for the end here? Matt Hardy, version one. Ooh, a headbutt. Matt Hardy's in full control of this match right now. Right now at this point, he's just trying to weaken Gold Dust so he can put him away finally. Stop him from countering that twist of fate. So far right now, Matt Hardy's doing a great job against Gold Dust. Oh, he missed. He barely got Gold Dust on that one. I don't know if he missed or if he only got a little bit of him, but either way, it didn't really work for Matt Hardy there. Arm drag by Gold Dust. A right hand though from Matt Hardy. Tries to go for that arm. Oh, but Gold Dust able to counter it with the elbow. And now, is this the original curtain call? The original curtain call. Hooks the leg. One, two. No, another kick out. The resiliency of Matt Hardy is just amazing right now at this point. Gold Dust tried to pull him away with his original move, the curtain call, the original move they used in his debut for World Wrestling Federation. And now Goldust still not able to put him away here in Fight Zone Wrestling. Twist of fate, no, a side effect, excuse me. But Goldust is able to counter that too. Hooks the arms for a tiger driver perhaps. Oh! He drove him on his head instead. One, two, Goldust did it! Goldust is the new number one contender for the World Championship. Goldust finally put Matt Hardy away. I'm shocked. I thought this was Matt Hardy's chance right now. I thought this was his time. But apparently it's not. Goldust did everything, literally everything in his moveset to beat Matt Hardy. And finally, Goldust puts Matt Hardy away.
Who is your winner?
With what seems to be a whole brand new move here tonight. Putting Matt Hardy face first into the mat with like a modified pedigree, it seems. I think that's the move that Andre the Giant has used years in Japan. Stevie Ray calls it the slapjack. We'll be right back. What an amazing moment tonight.
No fear, no fear. Blood, sweat, no tears. My God, my God. God's grace, I'm here. No fear, no fear, blood, sweat, no tears. My God, my God, hope we make it through the years.
How many know it will yet? How many else's equal drive?
Welcome back to Fight Zone Wrestling. You're watching Raw. And now it's time to say goodbye to Dean Ambrose. The Shield makes their entrance one last time here in Fight Zone Wrestling. Seth Rollins, Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose. Here we go! On Monday Night Raw, but can they get one more victory tonight? Will they get it over Leo Rush and Bobby Lashley tonight? Even though this is just a two-on-two match, Dean Ambrose still in the corner of his brothers, Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. The Shield. The Shield. One last run here in Fight Zone Wrestling. As you all know, Dean Ambrose is leaving Fight Zone Wrestling as well. You may not have known that, but he's leaving Fight Zone Wrestling as well. And tonight is the last time we'll see Dean Ambrose with Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins. So this is an incredible moment here on Fight Zone Wrestling, here on our main event. The farewell tour of Dean Ambrose ends tonight. When he's the hype man for Bobby Lashley, and Bobby Lashley is the muscle for Leo Rush. These guys are a great team. Bobby Lashley right now is the world champion, though. That's saying a lot. Leo Rush currently managing the world champion. This is Leo Rush's debut in Fight Zone Wrestling, his debut match here tonight. Here comes Walking Armageddon, the boss, Bobby Lashley.
And his partner from Colorado Springs, Colorado, weighing in at 273 pounds, the World Heavyweight FZW Champion, Bobby Lashley.
Hard hitting, soft spoken. The Destroyer is back to dominate. He goes by many nicknames. A lot of people know him as Bobby Lashley, though. It doesn't matter what you call him. It's the same guy. He's doing it all. That's why he's on top of Fight Zone Wrestling right now. This is your main event. Let's see if the Shield can get one last victory, get one last W before they get up out of here. Let's see what goes down. Here we go. There's the bell. Seth Rollins is gonna start Leo Rush for his team. Oh, he ducked that clothesline, but he didn't get that second one. Seth Rollins takes him down. Complete shot. Reverse flatliner. Nice counter there by Leo Rush. I expect to see a lot of great wrestling between these two athletes right now. Good God, the rights from Seth Rollins are just brutal right now. He's not stopping. Leo Rush is forcing him to stop, though. Wait a minute. He goes after Roman Reigns. Powerbomb by Leo Rush on Roman Reigns. Seth Rollins turns him around, turns him inside out. Seth checking on Roman Reigns, making sure he's all right. Roman Reigns back on the apron. Here we go. He got caught off guard by Leo Rush. I think the best thing, in my personal opinion, would be for Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns to let Leo Rush make a tag to Bobby Lashley. Let Bobby Lashley get in there so they can weaken Bobby Lashley and take him down. Or just keep Leo Rush in there. Hope he never tags Bobby Lashley. And they get a win over Leo Rush because Bobby Lashley has been so dominant. We're about to see what happens right now. Roman Reigns, I think, wants Bobby Lashley in. And that's what we're going to see right now. Bobby Lashley runs into an elbow. Look at this. Bobby Lashley with the clothesline taking down Roman Reigns. Oh, but Roman Reigns takes down Bobby Lashley. Only one guy didn't get back up from that one. And that was Bobby Lashley, the world champion. Seth Rollins earning the nickname Beast Slayer. Is he going to be able to take down Bobby Lashley, though? Bobby Lashley has said on multiple occasions he's better than Brock Lesnar. Is he? We would have to see that match again here in Fight Zone Wrestling. But Bobby Lashley did indeed pin Brock Lesnar for a 3 count. It did not count, though. The referee says it was only a 2 count. You look at the replay, though, it was indeed a 3. Brock Lesnar kicked out after a 3. But Brock Lesnar was able to beat Bobby Lashley with the F5 afterwards soon and got that victory. So right now at this point, it doesn't even matter, though, because Bobby Lashley's a world champion and Brock Lesnar has been nowhere to be seen. We haven't even seen Paul Heyman ever since that ECW thing didn't work out. But right now, Bobby Lashley, it worked to his advantage because he became the new FZW world champion after defeating The Miz 1-on-1. Seth Rollins goes down. It's been about 10 years. 10 years ago, Bobby Lashley, he headlined WrestleMania with Vince McMahon and Donald Trump and Stone Cold Steve Austin and Umaga. It was Bobby Lashley versus Umaga. Bobby Lashley getting the victory over Umaga, and because of that, Vince McMahon was shaved bald. Look at Leo Rush. Went for his frog splash, and it didn't work. Seth Rollins, also another guy that does a beautiful frog splash. Will we see him do it here tonight on Leo Rush? Nice reversal there by Leo Rush. Goes behind. Schoolboy. Ooh, into an enziguri. Picks him back up. Elbow. Elbow again. Goes behind again. Another enziguri. If it works, why not do it again? Jesus! I didn't expect it that time. Third time's the charm. He's too close to the ropes, though. Oh, look at this. Leo Rush going after Roman Reigns now. Drop kick. Didn't drop Roman Reigns, though. Oh, but that clothesline dropped Leo Rush. Roman Reigns was just simply defending himself at that point, even though he didn't need to defend himself. I mean, he had control of Leo Rush. Leo drops him off the apron, though, again. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Leo Rush. This is incredible right now, man. Leo Rush, he's so incredible. Oh, the boot to the face of Seth Rollins. And oh, look at Roman Reigns now. Roman Reigns has a hold of Leo Rush. Where's he gonna go now? There's nowhere for him to go. Oh, wait a minute, he's able to get out of it. Leo Rush is very quick, he's very fast. That's what Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns need to look out for. Seth Rollins known to be very quick himself, but Leo Rush is a whole different level. He's in a whole new gear of speed. Look at that, how he moved out of the way that time. Now another clothesline. That's what's working for Leo Rush right now. Bobby Lashley, he is definitely at about 98%, I think. If Leo Rush can make the tag, that's dangerous for Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins, who have been in this match already. Especially Seth Rollins. Roman Reigns turns things around on Leo Rush finally. He's getting tired of Leo Rush messing with him. Seth Rollins with a drop kick to the back of the head. Schoolboy and a super kick. Seth Rollins likes to call that the Abracadabra. I don't know what the hell he calls it. It's a super kick though. Here we go now. Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins giving the advantage. Uh-oh, look at this. The stomp. The stomp from Seth Rollins. Down goes Seth Rollins. Here comes Bobby Lashley to try to make the save. He knows he's in danger. But wait a minute. Oh, my God. Bobby Lashley just destroying Roman Reigns. This is not good. He's going for the spear. Oh, Roman Reigns jumped over. Wait a minute. Spear on Bobby Lashley. But look at Leo Rush. Leo Rush in Seguri. That speed again, like I said earlier. Another one. That time it didn't work. Ooh, uppercut. And now Roman Reigns is in control. Seth Rollins, I don't know if he's back up on the apron or not. Superman punch by Roman Reigns. Hooks the leg. One, two. They did it. The Shield walks away with another victory tonight in our main event. What an incredible night for Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins, and Dean Ambrose in their corner tonight. Congratulations to the Shield. They walk away with a victory here in their last night in Fight Zone Wrestling. Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen.
Here are your winners, Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns.
When you think about the things that these two have done for you. What the hell? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Wait a minute. Hey! Reigns just take out Seth Rollins!